In this question, we are given that two balls of same mass and carrying equal charge are hung from a fixed support of length L, and the strings are of length L, and at electrostatic equilibrium, assuming the angle made by each thread is small, then the separation x between the ball is proportional to. We need to find the relation between the separation between balls and the string length L. So here we can first visualize the case. If this is a fixed support and there are two balls which are hanging from the support and these are carrying equal charges, say plus Q and plus Q, due to which there will be an electric repulsion acting on the two, and the separation between the two balls is given as X and the string is of length L. And here we can see if this angle is theta, then we can see if weight is acting in downward direction, a string tension T is in upward direction, and here this angle will also be theta. So if we balance the forces in equilibrium, this will be T cos theta in upward direction and T sin theta in horizontal direction. So we can write in equilibrium position for balls, we use, here we can write T sin theta is equals to the electric force, which is KQ square by X square, or K we write as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q square by X square, and in vertical direction we write T cos theta is equals to mg. So if these are equations 1 and 2, then 1 by 2 gives, here we get tan theta is equals to F by mg. We can substitute the values also, this Q square by 4 pi epsilon naught mg X square. And we are given that theta is small, so we can write for a small theta, we use tan theta is approximately equal to sine theta, which is equals to x by 2L. We can write in this triangle, this is x by 2, so sine theta is x by 2L. So here we are getting x by 2L is equals to Q square by 4 pi epsilon naught mg x square. Here we'll slightly rearrange the terms, then we get the value of x is equals to, this 2 gets cancelled out, and we are getting Q square by 2 pi epsilon naught mg, this L to whole power 1 by 3. So here we can see X is directly proportional to L to power 1 by 3. So in this situation, answer to this question is option D.